My name is Victoria Liao, and I will be presenting the plant of the month. This month, we have the swamp sunflower, also known as Helianthus angustifolius. It is a perennial plant. As you can see on this picture, the plant has very narrow leaves. This plant does not have its flower yet. The only things that you can see right now are the leaves, and there are very little hairs on the leaves and on the stems. It's hard to tell with this picture, but there's that. And it's a dark green. It can grow up to 3 feet when it's fully grown, but in this picture, it's only about 1 foot, 1 foot and a half at most. The flowers can be up to 2 inches. It likes a medium amount of water. It also likes partial shade. So try putting it under a tree or maybe with some shade with a roof or something where it's being hit half of the day and then the other half it's just being in the shade. It also likes any soil that's kind of sandy, loam, or clay based. It's suggested that you add it to your landscape between May and July and in zone 8, which is like Hill Country, Austin, San Antonio area, and between April and August in zone 9. Which is our area in the coastal prairies. Leave space between 18 to 24 inches because these plants do tend to spread to each other and make a little system underground. But once they shoot up from the ground, you're able to just dig them up and move them, put them wherever you want, give them to friends, whatever you like. This is a Florida native, so it's able to tolerate our heat and humidity quite easily. They're very low maintenance, and they'll thrive if you give them a little extra fertilizer. They don't need it to survive, though. They're only really susceptible to powdery mildew and spittle bugs, but they rarely ever do extensive damage to the plant. As you can see on this map, they range from anywhere from New York to Florida, all the way to Texas. They are, like their name indicates, a swamp sunflower, so they'll be found in swampy, wet areas. It's down here because we tend to be very humid. It also likes the shade, so it's found in forests. The benefit it has is that it is very good for the ecosystem. It is very important for bees, and it's very important for the silvery checker spot butterfly, where it's its host. And the butterfly will lay eggs under the leaves, and then the caterpillars will hatch and have immediate food from the leaves. And they'll spend their whole life cycle just, and they'll create a cocoon, and then they'll leave and lay their eggs there again. The swamp sunflower also attracts sunbirds, quail, and deer. And they're able to use the seeds as nutrients and fat-rich foods in the late fall and winter. They are considered threatened in Illinois, New York, and Pennsylvania. The swamp sunflower is considered a facultative wetland plant, and it is not a weed or invasive, so do not pull these out. And that is all. Thank you for listening to my presentation.